Hey everybody, it's Thursday. Well, technically I'm posting this on Friday, but that said, I am back for another video. But yeah, hi everyone, have an amazing, have a nice few days. Now today I'm going to be talking about my Canada trip, so like I said, I was going to, so I'll tell you everything that happened. But no, so as you know, I was in Canada for just under 2 weeks, and I quite possibly had the best time of my life. We did so much stuff, we covered so many things, and it was just physically just one of the most amazing times of my life. So just before I start, I want to say thank you to Juan and Ryan for, you know, giving me such a good time. You know, I'm never going to forget it. Like, it's definitely one of those sort of highlights in my life, so thank you guys, I had such an amazing time. But no, so, you know, to start off, obviously, I didn't pack until, like, 2 days before I left, because I'm really bad at packing, so I, like, packed all my stuff, pretty much rushing around trying to get everything, and, on the first morning, obviously, I caught the train up to London, because, obviously, I was staying with my friend Wan before I went. So I went up to London, sort of met Wan, hung around for the day, and then got ready to go to the plane for the next day. So we got to the airport, sort of went through customs, all that kind of stuff, and it was scary going through security, because I've never done this kind of stuff before by myself. So obviously I took my belt off, took my shoes off, all that kind of stuff, just so they didn't set the alarm off. And I walked through the thing, and I was a bit kind of like, oh my god, this thing better not go off, this thing's better not, like, crocking. So it didn't go off or anything, but that was okay. And oh my god, as soon as I got on the plane, right, we were getting ready to go off, and you just heard this, I want my mummy. Oh, I hate children who whine. And there was a baby crying place pretty much the whole way. There was that stupid girl who was saying how much she wants her mummy. I'm thinking to myself, where is she? If she's not on the plane, why are you saying you want her? What are they gonna do? What are we gonna do? Make your mother fucking appear? Shut up. Shut up. But no, so he arrived, and as soon as I got off the plane, it was like walking into an oven. It was so hot. Because I was in jeans, I had a jumper on, because obviously, it was so cold, obviously, in England before I left, and obviously in the plane it was quite chilly, so, oh my god, it was like walking into an oven. So I went through all the things and did all that kind of stuff, and going through the flipping security bit at the end, with the, you know, the police officers that asked you questions, it was so scary. They were like, why are you here? Who are you coming to see? Have you been here before? Who are you staying with? What's the address? How do you know them? And it was like, just leave me alone. It was so scary. I was like, oh my god, they're not gonna let me in or something, because I was so nervous. So as I went through to the bit where everyone meets you, it was so scary, because I walked through and there were like a wall of eyes just looking at me and looking like, just, who is it, like, looking if it's the person they know. So I walked in, I was like, oh my god, all these people are staring at me. And I was looking around for Ryan, because he was the person I was meeting. And all of a sudden I saw this massive person just walk beside me. I was like, oh my god! So I, like, jumped on him and hugged him, all that kind of stuff. And yeah, so we did a lot of driving around when we first got there, just showing us everywhere and, you know, looking around places. And I cannot believe how tall the buildings are. Like, I thought London, in England, I thought we had big buildings until I went to Toronto. I can't understand how they're so huge. Like, they're massive, absolutely fucking massive. So that was amazing. I loved looking at that. That was really good. But we went shopping, so I wanted to buy some shorts. And it was so odd, because it was so weird walking around and not understanding people, even though I was in England. Like, I was in an English-speaking place. I couldn't understand what people were saying, and it was such a bizarre thing. Like, when I went to the shop to buy my sandals, I was like, Warren, will you do it for me? Because I was so scared. I was so scared that the person behind the counter would say something to me, and I wouldn't understand them. The second day, we went to an arcade called Dave & Buster's, and it's actually amazing. It's so fun. It was so much fun. We did loads of arcade games, went on, like, motorcycle things. I wish I did some filming in there, actually, but I didn't, and I don't know why. I wish I did, but... No, so that was absolutely fun. And we won loads of things. I bought loads of glow sticks with the tickets we won. And then we went to one of Warren's friends' house, and we went round by the, because they had a pool in the back garden, so we, like, landed around the pool because it was so hot that day. It was absolutely boiling. So we went around the pool, did, like, mucked around the swimming pool, the kind of things, and then it happened. There was a humongous thunderstorm, and it just, I mean, roared down. And I was like, oh my god, it's so scary. But I loved it so much because it was like flash, 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 constantly flashing all the time. And it was so, like, I'm not used to that kind of thing, and it was so amazing. But no, I absolutely loved that. And then we went downtown to his downtown apartment and started pre-drinking because we were going clubbing out that night. So went clubbing, did all the kind of thing. I met some new people, which was nice. The club we went to, it was so weird. Like, there was a sex room in this club. The barn, it's called The Barn, and there was a sex room. Dirty bastards. Dirty bastards. A hookup room. But no, so the next day, Warren had to go for an exam, so me, Ryan, and one of Warren's friends went downtown and got some food, hung around for a bit. And then we met another friend who I was really, like, eager to meet, so that was really nice. And we went down to another shopping mall and did some more shopping, all that kind of thing. And we went clubbing again that night, so got pre-drinking again, and went clubbing again to another place called Cruisin' Tango's, and we watched a drag show. And I've never seen a drag show before in my life, and it was so much fun. It was so fun. And Ryan was going mad because he was like, he loves drag queens. He was trying to talk to them. kind of like trying to give them money and things, and it was so funny, it was so funny. So drag shows are so cool, they're like absolutely hilarious. So then Friday we went down to Warren's uncle's cottage, which is, oh my god, right. Let me just say, this place was absolutely beautiful. I absolutely love this place. This is like the living area, and there was like, the stuff, and then there's the kitchen, and then there was like there's massive rooms upstairs. I didn't actually film upstairs, I wish I did now. There's massive rooms upstairs. Then there was like a lakeside, like on like the deck, like literally a dock on the lakeside, and that was absolutely gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. I loved it, that place, it was so fun. And basically when we were there, I met pretty much all of Warren's friends. So I love all of you guys, I miss you so much. Like, you guys, I love you all. And we had like pretty much like a 3-day party where we were just drunk and mucked around and just did loads of stuff. It was quite possibly one of the best weekends I've ever had. It was just so much fun. Yeah, thanks guys for such an amazing weekend there. That was so much fun. By the time Monday came, we went back to Toronto, and we kind of had like a chilled out evening because obviously we'd done so much on the weekend. We were all kind of like really tired, so we didn't really do much on that day. And then when Tuesday came again, we went to Niagara Falls, which was absolutely amazing. Niagara Falls was so beautiful. And then we went back down there at night time to watch, look at it at night, because they light it all up and make it look really pretty. So there's all these lights there, and it looks so good, it looks so good. I absolutely loved it. Went to a casino as well. Went to the casino at Niagara Falls and sort of did some gambling. I wasn't able to obviously to film inside there, because obviously not allowed to, but it was so nice in there. Like, oh my god, it was so, like, it was crazy. But I never realised how compulsive some people are to gambling. Like, there was this one woman who was on 2 slot machines at once. She was going, go, 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 and I was like, I went on a slot machine and I played roulette and stuff, and it was so much fun. Obviously I lost my money, but I didn't really mind because it was such fun. But yeah, it was really cool going to a casino. So then the day before we left, which is on Wednesday, we went to Wonderland, which is like a big theme park, and had such a fun time. I still think Thor Park in England is better than Wonderland, but Behemoth at Wonderland was absolutely intense. It was absolutely amazing. It went so high and just dropped you down. It was so much fun. Me and Warren were basically like screaming the whole way with their hands up. It was so much fun. Absolutely loved it. But the other roller coasters hurt you. Like, they actually hurt your neck and your like shoulders and stuff. And I was just like, how do people do this over and over again? Because I would end up with bruises. Like, it was actually painful. And then went clubbing again that night, went to the barn again and had another night of partying, which was quite fun. And then next day, obviously, we're all coming home. So we dropped Ryan off at the airport. And then after that, me, Warren and his friend went to a restaurant because I really wanted to see her again, and I really wanted to sort of like, sort of just sort of sit down and do nice things. But now there's a story about this, and it's a bit of a weird one. Basically, when we got to the restaurant, we all sat down and had like ordered our food and things. Me and Warren got our food, but his friend didn't get her food. We were waiting for ages, and like 20 minutes later, our food was getting cold, and obviously I started eating because obviously I don't want to eat cold food. The manager came out and was like, I'm sorry for the wait, because you had to wait so long, we are now going to pay for your food. So she got her food for free. And so we were eating, and about 20 minutes later, we heard this noise, and I was like, what is that noise? It was like, ugh! I was like, what is going on? So I look round, and there's this guy puking on he's actually being sick on the floor, and he's like being sick all over the floor. And I was like, oh my god, is there something wrong with the food? What's going on? And the weird thing was, he just sat there and didn't move, and I was like looking at them, and I was like, what is he doing? Like, why is he just sitting there? And then he did it, he was like sick again. He was like that, and it went all through his hand and onto the floor. And I was like, oh my god, why is he not going to the bathroom? Why is he staying there? And then he didn't wash his hand or anything, and he was like rubbing his face, rubbing his hair. So Warren went to go complain and was like, I don't want to sit outside, there's someone being sick and you're not doing anything, so take us inside please, because we don't want to eat by it. And the manager was like, I'm really sorry about this, blah blah blah, we are now going to pay for all of your meals. And we were like, oh! Complaining gets you somewhere. So we got all of our meals paid for. So that was so funny. So basically we had a free meal. But that was funny. So then went, got ready to go to the airport. Obviously got home. Like went, did the flight. The flight home was okay, because obviously I slept most of the way. So it kind of went really quickly. So got home, got my luggage and all that kind of thing. Then you know what happened when I got home, because obviously I became a YouTube partner. And just like, you know, I can't wait to see you guys again. Like, we have to meet up again soon. And thanks for all of you guys for sending me nice messages, you know, wishing me well on my holiday. And okay, so now obviously, like I said, I'm gonna be doing question of the day. So my question for this one is, what are some of your most memorable holiday moments? Oh my god, I'm sorry. Rudeness. What are some of your most memorable holiday moments? What are some of the things you've loved doing? What, like, just sort of tell me some of your best times on holiday. Or vacation, as you call it. So quickly, here are my comments of the video from last time. The first one comes from Mike My Day. When I got back from Italy, I realised how much I miss carpets. Seriously, the entire country has something against carpets. I love my feet to be comfortable. Now, I was laughing so much when I read that comment. It was so funny. Like, I love carpets myself. I love the really spongy ones. But that was so funny. Like, it was actually hilarious. Now, my second comment. I couldn't just pick one because so many of you said this. And a lot of you, what you were saying to me, you know, we have KFC in Canada, because I said how much I miss KFC. But the difference is, your KFC in Canada is actually different than ours in the UK, because we have different foods and ours, we have different things we can have. That's why I missed our one so much, so, like, don't think I was just going mad. Okay, I'm going to end this video now, because it's gone on for way too long. I'm sorry for the really long video, but there was so much I had to say. If you've watched this entire video, comment down below and say, Ungasha! Just comment down below and say that. Obviously, you know, I just want to see if you've watched it all. Ungasha!